Elon Musk has just introduced the amazing new Spaceship 2.0 from SpaceX. He is a multi-talented billionaire with a vision for the future that allows him to build next-level or future-focused items. He is most known for his tech firms Tesla and SpaceX. Despite his numerous mentions of developing a city on Mars, he's been working on a vehicle that might revolutionize space travel. It's a totally reusable transport system called a Starship that can carry 100 people to Mars. However, he just demonstrated a new version of Starship 2.0, which sounded better than ever before. But what is this new spaceship? And how does it work? Keep on watching to find out. So, what is this new spaceship? The shortest distance between Earth and Mars is around 33.9 million miles, and Musk hopes to transport over 1 million people to Mars by 2050. Musk added that in order for the colony to be self-sufficient, it would need to carry 1 million tons of material from Earth. This would be too expensive, therefore Musk must devise a cost-efficient but effective method of transporting humans between planets. That's when Starship 1.0 was revealed. Let's take a look at the present first generation of Starships, the Starship 1.0, to get a sense of how enormous Starship 2.0 is. When completely loaded with the Super Heavy rocket booster, Starship 1.0 rises approximately 400 feet tall, taller than the Statue of Liberty. It also dwarfs the Saturn V, the rocket that sent American men to the moon as part of NASA's Apollo program. Since 2019, the massive rocket has gradually evolved into a silvery sentinel made of stainless steel alloy. The Starship's diameter is 30 feet, making it larger than any previous orbital spacecraft and allowing it to transport vast amounts of goods, massive celestial observatories, or possibly many people. The Starship is more powerful than any previous known rocket in human history in terms of power. The rocket can launch almost any space payload, including passengers and satellites. Elon Musk has mentioned repeatedly over the years that one of the key goals of the Starship is to colonize Mars. According to him, 2 billion pounds of goods will be sent to Mars. SpaceX has stated their intention to mass-produce Starships and go to distant areas of the solar system. The company's Mars program has been repeatedly delayed, despite Musk's optimistic predictions. Starship is launched into space atop the Super Heavy rocket booster, which stands at 226 feet tall. After passing through the rigors of Earth's atmosphere, the two halves of the spacecraft separate at the edge of space. The Super Heavy launcher that propelled Starship off the ground returns to land near its launch pad as the spaceship moves closer to orbit. A gigantic tower with artificial arms, dubbed chopsticks by Musk, will try to grasp the descending rocket and carefully land it. The Starship 1.0 is an expendable rocket that can deliver up to 550,000 pounds of any cargo it needs to orbit. The Starship 1.0, on the other hand, has a maximum payload capacity of just 150 tons if it were a fully reusable rocket. A gigantic ship like that is required to serve as a reusable colony wagon as well as a space liner to transport passengers and cargo back and forth. However, considering the payload required to construct a self-sufficient city on Mars, Starship 1.0 is insufficient. The next generation of Starships, called Starship 2.0, will be double the size of the spaceships that will take people and cargo to the moon and Mars. Elon Musk said on Twitter that Starship version 2.0 will be 18 meters in diameter rather than the previous 9 meters. He made the remarks in response to a question about his plans to build a larger version of the Starship in the future from one of his many Twitter followers. This would give Starship 2.0 a height of 775 feet and a width of 60 feet. It would be the world's widest rocket, the cross-section area would be 4 times larger, and the capacity would be 9 times larger than the Starship 1.0. For the ultra-heavy Starship 2.0, the engines will most likely be updated. As a result, the future rocket might be capable of launching roughly 1,000 tons every launch, doubling a circle's diameter quadruples its area. A possible Starship 2.0 with a doubling in height would have 8 times the surface area and 8 times the propellant tank volume, requiring about 8 times the thrust and making the spacecraft 8 times as heavy as Starship 1.0. That would imply that the next generation of SpaceX Super Heavies may deliver payloads weighing up to 1,764 million pounds to low Earth orbit, also known as LEO, the Moon, and Mars. If orbital refueling is possible, this equates to around 800 metric tons. Now that we know what this spaceship is, how does it work? There are several tests that must be completed before a Starship may fly. The SN8 prototype was the first complete Starship prototype, following previous iterations that steadily improved various aspects of the design. The vehicle was conducted to 4 static fire tests between October and November 2020, all of which resulted in damage to the pad. The third test absorbed fragments of pad material into the engine's internals, leading it to shut down early. After a successful fourth test, SN8 launched to the air on December 9, 2020, reaching a height of 7.8 miles before performing the belly flop maneuver. SN8 regained vertical moments before landing and attempted to land, but due to a fuel supply issue, smashed into the landing pad at high speed, killing itself. Starship SN9 followed a roughly identical flight path 2 months later. On February 2, 2021, with a thud, it landed. The FAA has been looking into both the SN8 and SN9 flights since the explosion's debris threatened the nearby area. In March 2021, the firm introduced a public development plan that comprised 2 suborbital launch pads, 2 landing pads, 2 prototype test stands, and a large fuel tank farm. Musk will need extremely strong engines to pull off a rocket this huge. We're talking about the Starship 2.0, of course. To get this rocket off the ground, 60 Raptor 1.0 engines would be required. Thankfully, Elon has been working on the Raptor 2.0, a more powerful engine. The Raptor is the world's first full-flow staged combustion rocket, the newest generation of the methane-fueled engine known as Version 2, also known as V2, has been developed throughout time. Compared to the first version, V2 is a full redesign with less complex turbo machinery that produces higher power due to its ability to take in more fuel. To improve the engine's efficiency, engineers entirely rebuilt the nozzle, combustion chamber, piping, and electronics. More power, less parts. According to the company, Raptor V2 engines are put together, reducing the number of components that make up the engine. This makes the V2 engine more compact and easier to construct than the Raptor V1, which required flanges to connect all of the engine pieces. Elon Musk posted an update on Twitter, implying that Starship's orbital maiden voyage is approaching. Each Raptor 1 engine generates 185 metric tons of force. Raptor 2 has just begun development and will be capable of 230 tons of force, or over 500,000 pounds. In a tweet, he praised the Raptor 2 engine's greater performance. As a result, the Starship 2.0 would only require less than 60 Raptor 2 engines to take flight. SpaceX had a 12-meter diameter interplanetary transport system, also known as ITS, rocket design in 2016. ITS booster is one of 3 primary hardware components of a full architecture being developed by SpaceX for the exploration and settlement of Mars. The system, which was previously called as the Mars Colonial Transporter, also known as MCT, is made up of a reusable booster, an interplanetary spaceship, and a tanker vehicle for in-orbit refueling. Elon Musk updated his Twitter account, hinting that the Starship's orbital first journey is approaching. Elon said, "Each Raptor 1 engine generates 185 metric tons of force. Raptor 2 has just begun development and will be capable of 230 tons of force, or over 500,000 pounds. He hailed the Raptor 2 engine's improved performance in a tweet. As a result, the Starship 2.0 might lift off with as few as 60 Raptor 2 engines. In 2016, SpaceX developed an ITS rocket with a diameter of 12 meters. It was meant to send 300 tons into orbit and 450 tons to Mars with refueling. The ITS was almost twice as big as the present Starship Super Heavy, but it carried 3 times the cargo. The 18-meter Starship 2.0 would have 9 times the payload of the Starship if it had identical scalability. The 240-meter rocket would be twice the height of the Statue of Liberty and around 75% the height of the Eiffel Tower. In many cases, a larger spacecraft is beneficial. The ability of the strong spaceship to carry more cargo each trip will speed up the delivery of supplies to colonists, decreasing the number of trips required. The economic component of Starship 2.0 must also be considered. Musk said, "You don't just build a big rocket because you have a couple of billions lying around." Musk also mentioned that full reusability and efficient fuel utilization would reduce the cost of each Starship 1.0 launch to just $2 million. However, one journey on the Starship 2.0 is comparable to 8 travels on the Starship 1.0. The cost of launching the Starship 2.0 is anticipated to be $8.4 million, which includes $7.2 million for fuel and $1.2 million for support operations. On the other side, launching 8 Starship 1.0s would cost around $16 million. As a result, Starship 2.0 will essentially have the same costs for the same payload. The number of passengers in each batch on Starship 2.0 will also expand from 100 to 1,000. What do you think about Starship 2.0? Let us know in the comments.